Welcome back to Anatomy Dissected by Complete Anatomy. We will be finishing off our cranial nerve series. In this video, we will learn about the 10th cranial nerve, also known as the vagus nerve. We will first take a look at the function of the vagus nerve, then we will explore its course, and finally we will take a look at some clinical correlates. The vagus nerve is a mixed nerve, meaning it has sensory, motor, and parasympathetic functions. The vagus nerve receives sensory innervation from regions such as the dura mater of the posterior cranial fossa, the external acoustic meatus, the larynx, chemoreceptors of carotid bodies, the heart, and the gastrointestinal tract from the esophagus to the splenic fixture. It also receives taste sensation from the epiglottic region. The vagus nerve provides motor innervation to most of the muscles of the pharynx, soft palate, and larynx. Finally, the vagus nerve provides parasympathetic innervation to the heart, which helps regulate heart rhythm. It also provides parasympathetic innervation to the gastrointestinal tract from the esophagus to the splenic fixture. This stimulates digestive processes such as smooth muscle contraction and glandular secretions. The vagus nerve emerges from the medulla oblongata, just posterior to the olive, between the glossopharyngeal nerve and the accessory nerve. As we travel along the vagus nerve, we quickly come upon the first ganglion, which is the superior ganglion. This gives off the meningeal branch, which receives general somatic sensation from the dura mater of the posterior cranial fossa. The superior ganglion also gives off the auricular branch, which receives general somatic sensation from the anterior auricle, tympanic membrane, and the external acoustic meatus. The vagus nerve then exits the skull via the jugular foramen. We then find the inferior ganglion. This gives off three branches. First, we have the pharyngeal branch, which provides motor, sensory, and parasympathetic innervation to the pharynx, palate, and fossae. It also contributes to the pharyngeal plexus. The second branch from the inferior ganglion is the superior laryngeal nerve, which divides into internal and external branches. The internal branch supplies sensory and parasympathetic innervation to the epiglottis, root of the tongue, and upper larynx. The external branch supplies motor innervation to the cricothyroid muscles and the inferior pharyngeal constrictors. The final branch from the inferior ganglion is the carotid body branch, which receives sensory innervation from the chemoreceptors in the carotid body. The vagus nerve then penetrates and descends within the carotid sheath. Here, it is found between the internal carotid artery and the internal jugular vein. As the vagus nerve travels down, it gives off the superior cervical cardiac, the inferior cervical cardiac, and the thoracic cardiac branches. These all join to the cardiac plexus and provide parasympathetic innervation to the heart. The left and right vagus nerves take slightly different courses as they descend into the thorax. The left vagus nerve travels down between the left common carotid artery and the left subclavian artery. It curves laterally around the aortic arch and gives off the left recurrent laryngeal nerve. This nerve curves under the aortic arch and ascends. The right vagus nerve travels down and passes anterior to the right subclavian artery. Here, it gives off the right recurrent laryngeal nerve, which curves under the right subclavian artery and ascends. Both the right and left recurrent laryngeal nerves supply sensory and parasympathetic innervation to the larynx, esophagus, trachea, heart, and lungs. They also supply motor innervation to most of the muscles of the larynx. Going back to the left vagus nerve, it then descends anterior to the thoracic aorta and posterior to the left main bronchus. It continues anterior to the esophagus, where it eventually becomes the anterior vagal trunk. On the other hand, the right vagus nerve descends posterior to the right main bronchus and continues posterior to the esophagus, where it eventually becomes the posterior vagal trunk. The anterior and posterior vagal trunks pass through the diaphragm via the esophageal hiatus. In the abdomen, the vagal trunks terminate into their branches, which go on to provide sensory and parasympathetic innervation to the gastrointestinal tract from the esophagus to the splenic fixture. Damage to the vagus nerve can result in symptoms such as abdominal pain, difficulty swallowing, acid reflux, lack of the gag reflex, change in your voice, nausea, fainting, as well as changes to your heart rate and blood pressure. For example, vasovagal syncope is a condition in which the vagus nerve supply to the heart overreacts. This can be brought on by emotional stress, anxiety, or pain, for instance. This results in a sudden drop in blood pressure, followed by fainting. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of the vagus nerve, including its course down through the body into the abdomen, as well as its motor, sensory, and parasympathetic functions. Be sure to check out Complete Anatomy to learn more.